So let us understand what do we have with data science, and we are going to learn machine learning, okay, with Python as the language. Now, data science is all about data. Whenever we are talking about huge volume of data that we have gathered onto your big data, we understood its storage, we understood its processing using languages like Java and Scala. But then there is more beyond that. Okay, and at that point of time, we will have to go into a deep dive with your data science. Now, when I say data science, we have to make your machines learn, and we will first understand why we have to make your machines learn. Okay, and in order to make your machines learn, we need a language. Obviously, they are not going to understand what we speak as language. Okay, something that they understand, and that is Python. So, machine learning implementation with Python. We can do machine learning implementation with R as well, but Python is the most preferred just because it is free, it is easy to use, the syntaxes are not too complicated, and it has got a rich library for implementation of your machine learning algorithms. So even if we do not come from a data scientist background, or we are stepping ourselves into this industry for the first time, we end up having a smooth entry into this field just because Python helps us take care of all those things with a minimum coding. So there are many libraries inside which the complex code, the formulas are incorporated, okay, and we just have to give a call to those libraries within your Python programming and start utilizing. So that is what your machine learning is now to be done with Python, okay, here. So let us understand what is all this about when I talk about data science or machine learning. So let us understand that. So first is introduction. We know that in today's world, we have data coming from all sorts of medium in different formats, okay, and in huge volume and huge velocity. Okay, now data across the globe is captured onto computer. Okay, onto computers. It's all landing onto computer, and we already had an introduction to your big data systems for the same reason. So they are high in volume, it's varied in variety, and it is high in frequency, that is velocity as well. So data is now in terabytes and petabytes. Okay, data is now to be talked about in terabytes and petabytes. Next, what happens over there is when I talk about this data, every sector is capturing this data. So let's take, for example, banking. Banking as a sector or finance sector is capturing data, okay, and finding how people are spending their money. So spending patterns, okay. So how people spend money is what they want to find out so that they can put forward different products in front of the users. Hospitals, even hospitals start capturing their data, and they do a lot of thing inside that as well. Basically, the idea behind capturing information in hospitals is to track how people are responding to your treatments. Okay, so whatever treatments they are prescribing to patients, what treatments for which illness and how these patients are responding is what the data related to your hospital industry takes care of. Then talking about cars, automobile industry. Today we have smart cars, okay, wherein the engine is monitored constantly. Now this engine monitoring system constantly keep on streaming data, letting us know how the car engine is performing so that we can have mechanisms implemented to make your cars smarter. So if you see, there is varied variation in terms of the volume of data, in terms of the variety of data that it is coming, and everything is needed by everybody to provide better solutions to their customers. Challenges, we need to do something useful with this data. Okay, and for that reason, they are capturing this information. We all have learned, whether it be analysis system, whether it be storage system, we will only build a system in case we find something meaningful utilization of that so that we can either contribute towards the society or to your business growth. Okay, now let us start again with banking. What usefulness banks will do by capturing the information related to their customers and their spending patterns? So as I said, banks are capturing data in order to know how people spend money. Okay, so here, learning spending pattern. If they capture how people are spending their money, okay, in that case, they can easily identify fraud alerts, that is credit card alerts. Someone overpassing that particular limit quite frequently, okay, is obviously can be traced easily in case the bank is monitoring the spending patterns. Okay, then hospitals, what treatments for which illness, how the patient is responding. In that case, these hospital industry can go ahead and find out or identify treatments that don't work as expected and quickly, so that they can improve or they can incorporate improvements into that, okay, and make them better as well. When I talk about car monitoring systems, they capture this information so that they can make smart cars, okay, and we can then avoid your cars with giving you early failure warnings so that you don't get stranded into some remote area without help. So does all this make sense? Correct? Because all that data that we are capturing has to put for some meaningful utilization. So all these are some questions that machine learning can be used to answer. Okay, these are some questions that machine learning can use to answer, and it has varied application, okay, to any type of industry which wants to do something meaningful with their data. When I say machine learning, it is obvious human tendency. Now if you see, data comes in terms of numbers. Mostly when I am supposed to go ahead and do analysis, if you see, these are all numbers. Okay, now looking at these numbers, after some time all these start looking same, isn't it? If I have a big Excel sheet with 10,000 rows and I'm scrolling down, and all of a sudden everything looks same. Okay, so we cannot do something useful with it, because it is human tendency that the more complicated stuff I start looking at, okay, the more my mind drags myself away from it. And then even if there is some hidden pattern, some useful pattern available over there, I cannot identify. Okay, so over here, the size and the complexities of the data sets mean that humans are unable to extract useful information from them. Even the way that data is stored works against us. It's all numbers, it's all complicated. Given a file full of numbers, our minds generally turn away from looking at them for a long time. So this is what we exactly talked about right now. And then, what we need to do is, we need to do something of it. I just can't ignore myself just because it is complicated. I need to find a way out, or I need to take somebody's help to make this possible. And that somebody is nobody else but your machine. Okay? So machines are not replacing us. Machines are here to help us out. We will give this complex work of handling your huge volume of data, numbers, to your machines. And what we will do? We will just go ahead and take decisions. Okay? So the decision-making power is still under you. Machines are not replacing you for that. They are just helping you to take decisions. So, this is the reason why machine learning is becoming so popular. The problems of our human limitations go away if we can make your computers do the dirty work for us. Handle those complexities of data by machine, and we are just going to go ahead and take decisions. Okay, now, what is the end result of a machine? So if you look over here, these are end results of your machine learning. Okay, assume this data to be full of numbers in an Excel sheet. I couldn't make out anything out of it, but now as it is inside graphs, I can clearly make it out. What does it mean? As it is graph, it is clearly making out what does it mean over there. So all these are graphs out of what we are going to talk about inside machine learning. So if you were ever thinking, what will be the output of machine learning looking like? So this is exactly how it looks. Visuals. So even if I leave you with these visuals and you don't know anything about data science or anything data related stuff, then too you can draw conclusions.
You need to do the graphs, I need statistics.
Exactly. So that will be all done by your machine. We only have to feed in the formula to the machine. Okay. So if you see, if I leave you with these graphs, okay, you yourself can make a lot of conclusions out of it. So if you see, this is an organization which started in 2015 and till 2024, they look forward to grow their revenue, okay, this high. Okay, that means it's consistent growth, and that too across globe. Agree? Okay. Then if you see, this is some demographics data related to cats and dogs. Okay, this area is full with dogs. This area is full with cats. Okay, and there are some, you know, cats which are in the dogs area. Okay, they are quite brave enough to go there. So that's what you see here. Okay, and some dogs running behind cats over here also. So you can clearly see, okay, what it is. But if I would have given this to you as numbers, okay, it would have been difficult. Fine. This is some amount of classification that we are doing over there. Okay. So age and based on estimated salary, whether those people will purchase the SUV or not. So all these green areas, the dots indicate each person. So these guys are ready to purchase, or these guys will purchase the SUV. Okay. But there are some red dots in green area also, which are those who are not purchasing the SUV. Okay, and this complete area indicates that these guys within this age and salary will not purchase the SUV. So if you see, it makes more sense, okay, to go ahead and understand this when it comes down to be your visuals. So these are easy to interpret and these are great visuals. Okay, so this is exactly what your machine learning is going to give it to you. Algorithms. Okay, your machine learning will have algorithm implementation, and algorithms are nothing but your steps, okay, that you end up taking. So there would be a formula, what to do if that particular value is yes, okay, what to do if it is no, so on, so forth, the algorithms will be coded. Now these machine learning algorithms, knowingly or unknowingly, we have been a part of it, okay, all the time. Say spam filters. How does your mailbox distinguish between spams, inbox, okay? Say today in Gmail you also have promotions, social, okay? Automatic categorization happens, fine? There is no one person sitting and organizing your inbox. Google is doing automatically for you, okay? So those are also machine learning algorithms. How does it identify it's a spam? Automatically it identifies that this is something invalid, which you don't look forward to, you know, be a part of. Okay. So that's what you have, your spam filters. Computer games. We have been playing games on your mobiles or to your computer, and we have been competing with your computer. Okay. So there's nobody sitting inside my computer and playing with me. It's the machine itself. Okay. So we have taught machine how to play. Voice recognition. Okay, so today if you see, we have Google Assistant, we have Amazon Echo, okay, so many things over there wherein just on voice commands it goes ahead and identifies problems, okay, or gives you solution. So even if I tell my phone, okay, call so and so person, it can call, it will just give a call to it, okay. So that's what happens over here. We have voice recognition, again machine learning. Auto number plate recognition. So you have stickers on your automobile. Okay, many clubs and hotels do that, and automatically they get scanned and the gates open. At airports this happens. A lot of options are there now, okay, to do that. Then algorithm to decide whether bank will give loan or not. So every bank's homepage has that. Are you eligible for loan? Okay, we just feed in our information and they'll do that. Okay, we don't have to go and visit banks. Those were like gone are those doors wherein, you know, you have to have reference to manager, reference to this, that, to get your loans approved. But now machine is doing that task very conveniently for you. So machine learning, how do machines learn? Now, before ever we teach machines learn, don't you think we should understand how we as individuals learn? Isn't it? It's all about that. Who is training machines? Humans. So how will they train? They will not train how aliens think. Okay, they will obviously train how they think. Agree? So the pattern in which you approach to a problem, same way is what you would like your machine also to do the same. Okay? So let us understand basics of intelligence or human intelligence. So human intelligence or learning is made up of remembering, adapting, okay, generalizing. So basically over here, when a person starts thinking, okay, or learning something, these are the three things that he goes ahead and does. So say for example, we are learning how to cross a road. Okay, so what is your usual approach? You look left, you look right, and you cross. Or you will wait until the signal is red and you cross. Okay, then say you are in Mumbai and you did that. You learned how to cross the road. Okay, you come to Hyderabad. You look left, right, back, center, anybody, anywhere will they will come, right? So what you do, you adapt, you learn more ways of crossing road. Okay, you don't wait for signal to be green, you jump, you know, signal to be red, you jump when it is green. Okay, so you are adapting, and then again you go to another city, you generalize how you are going to cross the road. So these three things, right? You did something when the situation encountered for the first time. You changed your, you adapted yourself when you encountered the same situation in some another place. And eventually you started generalizing. Okay, so city to city, there are no different rules of crossing road. It is simple, similar. So that's called as generalization. And all these things is what we will make your machine also do the same. We will make your machine remember. We will make your machine adapt and then generalize. So when it goes to adaption on itself, there is where the artificial intelligence side comes into picture. Okay. So how can we model them in computer is the question. And machine learning is the answer to this. When I say machines, okay, we are supposed to make your machines learn, and eventually after learning, they are going to make predictions for us. Okay, so there might be a possibility that you have a machine which tells you whether to cross the road or not. Okay, so we are going to teach him how to cross the road. Okay, and he is going to give us a suggestion whether to cross it or not. So that's too weird thing, but if I just say weather app, okay, before I go out of my home, I will check whether it will rain or not. So it's predicting, right? Okay, based upon whatever data is there, it's giving me predictions. Okay, so there is where you have the predictions. So now machine learning is about making computers modify or adapt their actions. And they eventually land up performing accurate actions. Now when I say accurate actions, your accuracy is measured by how well the chosen action can reflect the correct ones. So over there, we need to understand, we don't give machines right and wrong indications. We give them score of accuracy. How accurate they are. They are 20% good. They are 98% good. 80% accurate. So based on that, the machine is going to eventually go ahead and adapt or learn things. Now, let's talk about a game, Scrabble. Okay, any problem, Azim Sai? Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about the game Scrabble. So we have been playing a lot of games, right, with machine, Counter-Strike, right, cars, and what all, Temple Run, chess. Okay, so many things. So Candy Crush. Okay, so one of this is Scrabble. So now Scrabble, we are playing against machine. So we have this machine. Okay, and we have this guy who is too happy to play with machine. And it is first ever time they are playing together. The game is just launched, assume. Okay, so now what happens is he's happy. So here what happens? The boy starts playing. He wins. Machine doesn't lose, machine learns, okay, machine learns. But he is very happy, I won against the machine, I beat the machine. Then again, he plays, he wins, machine learns, okay. Again, he wins, again, machine learns, okay. Again, he wins and the machine learns again. And now, machine starts beating him, okay. So it's like he wins And he's human, right? He's going to get sad. Yeah, he's not going to learn. Okay? So?
There's a website on Dream Level.
Okay.
They even do like this.
They do like this, right?
They do that starting and they offer.
All do like this only. Okay, starting you start winning, you get addicted, and then you start try to beat machine wherein you have already made that machine smart. Okay, so the machine has already learned how to win. So again, the person loses here. Okay, machine wins, he loses. So he says, okay, I'll get one of my friends who is smart in this game. He will beat this machine. So he gets that friend. Okay, so what happened is machine has remembered. Yes or no, machine has remembered and adapted to his playing style. Now another guy comes and he has some hidden moves that this guy didn't know. And he will beat that guy. I mean, he beat that machine. And he'll be happy, oh, I won again. But then machine will start beating him again. In this process, when machine starts playing with the second friend of this person, the machine doesn't start learning from scratch. It generalizes. That's called as generalization. Okay? And it's not just his other friend. Across globe, it will start generalizing. So even Candy Crush, when it started seeing that people are becoming impatient and they want to cross that level after 5 moves, they started putting charges on purchasing more lives. And people also were like so impatient, they want to win only. And they started even, you know, purchasing those extra lives and so on. So that's how it is, okay? So machines learn with all these things that we just talked about. And that's how in real time also happens. So the more you interact with your machine, the better it gets. Even if you see with your voice commands, okay? When iPhone launched, they have this Siri inside it. Okay? She was not able to identify Indian accent. So if I say, dial Shrikant, like, even if it's there, she will not. It's not that she was biased. Okay? It's like she was not used to the way we talk because we really didn't talk much. Okay? So what happens over there is, now when we talk more, okay, there is more data. Google Assistant, Siri, they understand our accent more well. And now even if I say dial Shrikant, it'll track. Okay, so that's how it happens. Fine. So you can test it even when you use Google Assistant also. First time you say that, they may say that you didn't understand. Second time, third time, then the moment she understands, okay, this is what her pronunciation means, she starts giving you those answers correct. Okay. So here it is. So machine learning is a field that uses algorithms to learn from data and make predictions. We can feed data into an algorithm and use it to make predictions about what might happen in the future. Okay? But it will just predict. Whether to accept that prediction or not, okay, is up to us. So there are so many astrologers who sit, right? Okay? And they tell you this will happen. Maybe. It's a calculated game again. Okay, if somebody is good at reading things, they will predict properly. But that would be also with an accuracy of 80 to 90%. It is not going to be exactly the way they say it. Okay, but at least a guideline is what we get to be precautious or not to be precautious if we believe. Okay, so that's how exactly your machines are going to do. Fine. So if somebody is sitting with a parrot on the road, we can't trust that algorithm, right? I mean, parrot going and picking up a card and predicting future is, I mean, doesn't, you can't buy that theory, right? So same is over here. If you have a robust machine learning algorithm, which has a formula, calculated formula for predicting, and we have coded that, then it makes fine. So if I ever ask somebody, how is your machine predicting? They say, yeah, it's doing like this only. No, there has to be something, right? It cannot do like this only because your machines don't understand. We have made them understood. They can't listen. They can't hear. They will only understand what we tell them to do. Okay. So it is as good as like people. There's a Japanese scientist who says that machines will take humans. I mean, the theory of machines replacing humans is as good as, you know, the theory of submarines swimming. isn't it? I mean, it's same, right? You just can't relate that. Okay, so that's how it comes down to be. So machine learning is about all predictive analysis with some calculated formula that you feed in. So here, now this has vast range of applications. Example, self-driving car, stock price prediction. So stock price prediction also morning, you know, everybody's home will have those business channels on. Okay, and those stock brokers will sit and talk about and give you predictions. So if you have ever heard that, okay, they usually say book your profit in the range of 150 to 200. So they really don't tell you exact price. Why? Because their algorithm has given them range.
They also believe the car called Genesis. They was working on that. Like we set one car in front of us, in front of us. We set and automatically. If the front car goes in 60 kilometers per hour, goes in 60 kilometers.
And slows down if he slows down.
If he brakes after the break, our car also will be slow.
Oh, that's good.
20 tons in the car.
Is it?
Yes, 20 tons in the car.
It's just you and one more person. Okay. The sensors are now becoming small. Okay. Fine. Now here. Done, Ramesh sir? It's happening?
Yeah, it's installed.
Installed, right? No worries. Now next is self-driving car. So, what do you think if I have to develop a self-driving car? What all information do we have to feed in? And that car needs to drive on Hyderabad roads. So, what all do you think? Okay, forget about Hyderabad roads, but still, right? First, what do you think we should give that car?
Right,
signals.
Signals.
Yeah, data, but what all data? Signals and
potholes,
and side crossings,
lane discipline.
No, that will be discipline. It's in our hand, right?
Navigation
exactly. Then
speed limits.
Then yeah, for him to have that artificial intelligence, okay. We need to give him all this information. Shortcuts will be in map only.
With the data, you can go on.
Which data? Mapping is there. Yeah. Driving rules. What else?
We give Google.
We give Google, it is enough, right? Yeah, what more? Google will only give you directions, right? Yeah, all those things it will give, right? Correct. But we also have to tell to interpret signal, right? Red means stop, green means go. Okay. What else?
And even if the zebra crossing is cleared out, we have to stop it, right?
He's thinking more from Hyderabad self-driving car. Yes, more intelligent, more human-like it is. Yes, we have to feed him. Yeah, I mean, it needs a lot of information, right? The most, and one more important thing, what your car should know. Human faces? Okay. It should not dash somebody crossing, right? It should brake, it should wait. Human faces it should be, right? Okay. So we have to feed in individual faces over there. Now look at the population. If we start moving inside, okay, human faces, it's quite identical. It starts becoming quite identical. We also have quite similar traits sitting in this class, right? So fine, we are similar people. So like that, we have to feed in. So all Indians database I feed in, but then again a Chinese comes, he dashes. Isn't it? Okay, object will come. So much of information in terms of those pictures, okay, has to go inside to that particular car, right? And eventually, street signs, everything has to go. So not just these things which are essential for driving, but it should identify everybody, That's an intelligent car, right? I just don't want that I a remote control car, it starts from here and it stops there. In between anything happens, it's not bothered. Okay, not like that. So we have to have a self-driving car with all these capabilities. So see the amount of data that we have to feed in. Okay, so all this is about telling machine, you have to feed in data, data and data, and with that only it is going to become intelligent. So more data, more questions, better solutions. Okay, that's how it goes ahead with. Fine. So exactly, that's how they are. Yes, see, one is as it is, same technology. It's all about machine learning only. Very minimum also we have sensors these days at your car when you're taking a reverse. Okay, it starts beeping in case there's an object coming closer. Okay, so these are minimum things. But then you have to tell. You have to tell that till what distance you should not beep. And after that, how you start beeping it. Okay, so that sensor is also continuously throwing some data. It's sensing something. How are we sensing the temperatures? Even that's what is happening, right? Okay, so all this is your machines getting fed with some data. Okay, and it's constantly going ahead and making you conveniently have some better solutions which makes your life easy. Okay, now machine learning will be supervised learning, wherein we will have to monitor how the machine is learning. Unsupervised learning, the machine will learn on its own. Okay, in supervised learning, we are going to give some background or history of data to the machine to understand what is happening in their system. Okay, and based on that, it is going to go ahead and give predictions. So say we want to predict salaries of newly hired employees. So what is the pattern of salary distribution of employees in the same experience area that we have hired previously? Machine will get an idea and predict accordingly. Okay, unsupervised learning, wherein we don't give them any history, we just give data and say predict. So say I give them say 1 lakh entries and I say group based on spending patterns of these people. So it will try to find out similarities. Okay, so there is nothing that I had to give to him to make him learn, okay, how to grow ahead and group people. It will generalize by looking into the information. So these are two broad categories that we have under the machine learning part, supervised and unsupervised. Okay, when I say supervised learning, a training set of examples with the correct responses, that is targets, is provided, and based on this training set, the algorithm generalizes to respond correctly to all possible inputs. So we have to give this training set to him. Okay, examples are linear regression, K nearest neighbors, decision tree, these are the algorithms, and more than these are there. Okay, just to few to name them is what I have listed. We will be implementing. Though we are going to talk about this topic in very much detail, this is just high level introduction. When I say unsupervised learning. So in unsupervised learning, correct responses are not provided, but instead the algorithm identifies similarities between the input and have something in common are categorized together. So algorithms like K-means cluster algorithm, anomaly detection. Didn't I tell you anomaly detection? People who are spending irregular patterns, in an irregular pattern, we can identify them. Okay. So here it is, more data, more questions, better answers. Machine learning algorithms find natural patterns in data that generate insight and help you make better decisions and predictions. See, everywhere, insist on the line, it will help you make. It will not make the decision and give. It will simply help you make. Okay? They are used every day to make critical decisions in medical diagnosis, stock trading, energy load forecasting, and more. Okay? All that is what they would be doing. So here it is, data and take decisions. Fine. And eventually this data, that decision is going to be data. So better data, better decisions. And today's decisions generate data for future. That's how it comes down. So this is like no best method or one size fits all. We may have worked even as a data scientist, okay? Even then, looking at the problem statement, I cannot give my final decision that this algorithm will be the best. Okay? You have to go through a process called as exploration and then go ahead and decide what exactly fits best. And one that fits best for that situation may not be a best fit for other situations. Okay, so we may end up landing into issues if I say this is the best for all situations, because that's not the situation. Okay, so you should always understand that there is no algorithm that is first 100% accurate, and there is no algorithm that is best for all situations. So there is no best method or one size fits all. So machine learning, we have supervised and unsupervised. Supervised learning is classified into classification and regression, and unsupervised is classified into clustering. Okay, now we will come down to this later when we start working with it. So any doubt?